Welcome. Today, we take a new chapter, Binomial Theorem, Part 1. This chapter is very helpful for any competitive exams like IIT Main and Advanced, State Level Joint Entrance, etc. I think you know all of the basic idea and formula of binomial theorem. I mention few of them. First thing is a plus x to the power n. N is any positive integer, and they together is called binomial. It has two terms. It is equal to, formula is, it nc0 a to the power n minus 0 into x to the power 0 plus nc1 a to the power n minus 1 x to the power 1 plus nc2 a to the power n minus 2 x to the power 2 up to Ncn minus 1 a to the power this minus that, that is 1 to x to the power n minus 1 plus Ncn which is 1 into x to the power n and a to the power 0 is 1. So a plus x to the power n for any positive integral value of n. We already in in basic school, we have seen a plus x to the power 2 or a plus x to the power 3. All these formula we know, they are also binomial. N is equal to 2. If a plus x cube, when the whole to the power 3, then n is equal to 3 and so on. This thing we know. And here it is actually generalized. If you want to find the binomial formula a minus x to the power n, only difference from this between this to that is x is replaced by minus x. Here also in on right hand side, simply by putting x is equal to minus x, we get the result. This is same thing, this will be same money nc0 a to the power n. Yeah, this x will be replaced by minus x, so this is negative. This x will be replaced by minus x whole square, so it will be positive, and so on. And last term will be minus 1 to the power n, ncn x to the power n. That's all. So, if we put sometimes we want a plus x to the power n. Here, only difference is with that is a is replaced by 1. So, all a on right hand side to be replaced by 1. So, it is nc0 into 1 to the power n plus nc1, 1 to the power n minus 1, that is 1, into x plus nc2. X square up to for this nc n minus 1 x to the power n minus 1 plus ncn x to the power n. Same case, 1 minus x to the power n, 1 minus x to the power n. This can be obtained from here simply by putting x by interchanging x by minus x. So it will be this is this minus that plus this minus that, alternately plus and minus will appear. General term of this binomial formula, it is normally we denote it by t r plus 1, which is r plus 1th term of that. It is equal to ncr x a to the power, their difference n minus r into x to the power r. So for any r, that is second term, third term, fourth term, for fourth term, this is 4, so we have to put r is equal to 3 here. We get the fourth term this way. It is very clear that from this that number of terms in that binomial is n plus 1, because the formula starts from here. You see nc0 corresponding to that 0, it is first term. Corresponding to nc1, 1, it is second term, third term. So it is n plus 1 terms. So any binomial distribution whose index is n have n plus 1 terms. Its middle term, how to calculate middle term? Suppose n is 20. It has 21 terms. So its middle term is 21 of the middle term of 21 terms, which is actually it is equal to t of n that is 11th term is the middle term. In that case, it is as because 20 n is 20, as because it is even integer, its middle term is that. If for the case say 41, if n is 41, it has 42 terms. So if it has, it must have two middle terms. Number one, t. Suppose for n, not 41, for n, when n is odd integer, its middle two middle terms, first middle term is n plus 1 by 2, and second middle term is t n plus next half term, this. For example, so if n is equal to say 5, total number of term is 6, so it has two middle terms. First middle term is t 6 by 3, that is t 3, and t 4. And once you know middle term is t 3 or t 4 or t 9, using that formula we can obtain that. The sum of all binomial coefficients of that, it is actually by putting a is equal to 1, x also equal to 1, then we get sum of the binomial coefficients, because binomial coefficient is this nc0, nc1, nc2 and so on. So this can be obtained by putting a is equal to 1 and x is equal to 1. So binomial coefficient is nc0 plus nc1 plus nc2 up to ncn. It is equal to, this is a formula. So here also we have to put a is equal to 1, x is equal to 1. So 2 to the power n. So this formula you have to keep in mind, you have to remember it. Similarly, if the binomial is this, so you can expand it. It is positive, it is negative, it is positive, it is negative, and so on. So sum of the coefficients will be n c 0, then it is minus n c 1, then plus, minus, and so on. And its value will be equal to, again we have to put a is equal to 1, x is equal to 1. So 1 minus 1 to the power n, that is 0. So here we get nc0 plus nc2, this, plus nc4, or if all even, plus is equal to. Now take this into other side. So nc1 plus nc3 plus nc5, and so on. So this is equal to that, number 1. And they are equal to 2 to the power n minus 1. Why? Because this plus that, they are equal. Again, this plus that is 2 to the power n. So this is equal to 2 to the power n by 2, that is that. All are very important to remember. You remember it, please. One more thing we have to keep in mind, that is, sometimes we are asked to find the kth term of that binomial from the end. From the beginning, we know, from the end. In that case, we can calculate what would be the kth term from the last, from the end. Or we can write this is equal to x plus a to the power n. This must be equal to that. Now, kth term of this from the end is equal to kth term from the beginning, which can be calculated very easily. Now consider this binomial ax plus b by x to the power, say 3 to the power n. Its terms are ax to the power n plus nc1 ax to the power n minus 1 into b by x cube to the power 1 plus nc2 ax to the power n minus 2 into b by x cube to the power 2, and so on. Now we see the what are the powers of x in subsequent terms. In the first, it is x to the power n. In second, it is x to the power n minus 1 minus 3. It is x to the power n minus 4. It is decreased by 3. It is decreased by 4. Next third term is this one. Its power is x to the power n minus 2 minus 6. Here also, the power of x in subsequent terms of n, n minus 4, n minus 6, and so on. So, in every subsequent term, power is decreased by 4. It is 8. Decreased by 4. Why 4? 1 for this and 3 for that. They together is 4. In every subsequent terms, power of x will be decreased by 4. It will help you for calculating problems. For what type of problem? Say it is given that 2x minus 4 by x square to the power 10. Calculate which term contains x to the power, say, 4. Which term of the binomial series contain x to the power 4? First term will contain x to the power 10, 2x to the power 10. So power of x is x to the power 10. In subsequent term, power of x will be decreased by 1 plus 2, that is 3, x to the power 7. Next term, x to the power 4, and so on. So without any lot of calculation, we can say that third term will contain x to the power 4, and so on. Next. Suppose this binomial is given, and just now we have seen that by putting x is equal to 0, x is equal to 1, and a is equal to 1, the sum of the coefficients is 2 to the power n. That is, 2 to the power n is equal to nc0 plus nc1, and so on. Now, differentiating both sides, this and that, we get n into a plus x to the power n is equal to n minus 1. Derivative of that, n minus 1. This is purely constant 0. Tale nc1 into a to the power n minus 1 into 1. Its derivative is, it is constant up to this. 2x into that, 2 nc2 a to the power n minus 2x plus next term 3 nc3 a to the power n minus 3x square, and so on. Now again, by putting a is equal to 1, x is equal to 1, this becomes n 2 to the power n minus 1 is equal to, this becomes it a 1 nc1 plus 2 nc2 1 1 plus 3 nc3, we get one sum of the series of few binomial coefficients with associated coefficient means multiplier of nc1 is 1, multiplier of nc2 is 2, and so on. This also will help a lot for calculating problem. Sometimes problem may be given like that: add this with 2 into that, then you get one result. What is that? Add this and 2 times that, it will be nc0 plus, no nc0 is there, then nc1, nc1 into 1 and nc1 into 2, I multiply here by 2 and this by 1, and then add. So this is nc1 at 2 nc1, that is 3 nc1 plus, this will be nc2, and that one will be 4 nc2, that together is 5 nc2, and so on. This result, nc0 plus n 3 into nc1 plus 5 into nc2, etc. This is equal to, we have to multiply this with 1 and that with 2. So it is 2 to the power n plus n into 2 to the power n, that is n plus 2, this is 2 to the power n, and this is also n into 2 to the power n. So 1 plus n into 2 to the power n is value of that. Sometimes this type of problem may be given. So one more result. This result is obtained by differentiating both sides of that one and putting a x is equal to 1 and so on. Similarly, you see, if we integrate this result, both sides with respect to x, I first integrate that. It is nc0 a to the power n x to the power 1 by 1 plus nc1 a to the power n minus 1 into x square by 2 plus nc2 a to the power n minus 2 x cubed by 3 and so on. In left hand side also we have to integrate. It is a plus x to the power n plus 1 by n plus 1 plus, and we have to add one constant in any side. I write constant is say a, and integration constant can be calculated by putting any value of x over there. Put x is equal to 0. In that case, this is 0, this is 0, all members of the right hand side is 0. So this is 0 is equal to, this one is a, and it is a to the power n plus 1 by n plus 1. Value of a is known now. A is equal to minus of that. So integrating that, we get the result nc0, this one, a to the power n, x to the power 1 plus nc1, a to the power n minus 1, x square by 2 plus nc2, a to the power n minus 2, x cubed by 3 and so on. You have to write up to last term. It is equal to this plus that, means a plus x to the power n plus 1 by n plus 1 plus a is equal to minus a to the power n plus 1 by n plus 1. Now, putting x is equal to 1, or rather a is equal to 1, x is equal to 1, we get a is equal to 1, x is equal to 1. We get nc0, this one is nc0 plus nc1 by 2 plus nc2 by 3 must be equal to right hand side of that, that is this. This is 2 to the power n plus 1, a is 1, x is 1. 2 to the power n plus 1 minus 1 by n plus 1. We get another series, sum of series, and each coefficient is divided by 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. So they are all helpful. In case of solving problems, I discuss it in detail. Okay, now let us take few problems. First problem is that ratio of seventh term, T7, of cube root of 2 plus 1 by cube root of 3 to the power n from the beginning and from end is 1 is to 6. Then n is once again, I repeat the problem, binomial, its seventh term from the beginning and seventh term from the end, their ratio is 1 is to 6. In that case, n is, value of n is the options are there. So from the beginning, T7, it is equal to T actually 6 plus 1. So it is NC6. First term is 2 to the power 1 by 3, that to the power n minus 6 into 3 to the power minus 1 by 3. This is 3 to the power minus 1 by 3. It is in denominator. That to the power 6. And for calculating T7 from the end, we write the series is just reversing the order. Cube root of 3 plus cube root of 2 to the power n. That is 3 to the power minus 1 by 3 plus 2 to the power 1 by 3. That to the power n. Its seventh term means in the first way, it is equal to NC6 into a to the power, this is a to the power n minus 6, meaning n minus 6 by minus 3 into 2 to the power 1 by 3 whole to the power 6. Then as per condition, this by that is equal to 1 by 6. So we get NC6, I am writing this, 2 to the power n minus 6 by 3 into 3 to the power minus 2 by this term by that term, NC6 into 3 to the power minus n by 3 plus minus of, it is n minus 6 by 3, so it has negative sign there, n minus 6, so it is 2 into 2 to the power 2. As per condition, it is 1 by 6. 1 by 6, the given ratio. 1 by 6 is equal to that. Now this cancels. So we get 2 to the power n by 3 minus 2, another minus 2, into 3 to the power minus 2, this become minus 2, minus 4, into, that is plus n by 3. This is equal to 1 by 6. So that by simplifying it, it is equal to 2 to the power n by 3 into 3 to the power n by 3 by 2 to the power 4 into 3 to the power 4 is equal to 6 to the power n by 3 by 6 to the power 4. Now all terms become in terms of 6 to the power something. So we get it 6 to the power 3, this is taken there. 6 to the power 3 is equal to 6 to the power n by 3. So 3 must be the same. So this is 3 is equal to n by 3. So n is equal to 9. This is correct option. Now our second problem. If 7 to the power 16 is divided by 50, the remainder is, option is 21, 18, 6 and 1. Problem is, if this is this term, 7 to the power 16 is a very big number, it is divided by 50, then what is the remainder? So this can be written as 7 square whole to the power 8, that is 49 whole to the power 8, that is 50 minus 1 whole to the power 8. So this is equal to that, is equal to, now apply binomial, it is 50 to the power 8, then minus 8c1 into 50 to the power 7 into minus 1, and this way we get plus, this way we get, last term will be the last but one term will be 8c7 into 50 into minus 1 to the power 7, and last term is 8c8 meaning 1 into 50 to the power 0 means 1 and 1. Last term is that. Now we see this is equal to that. This is divisible by 50, this is by 50, this is also divisible by 50. So all are divisible by 50 excepting that. So remainder is 1. Our next problem. Almost same type problem. If factorial 1 plus factorial 2 up to factorial of 95 is divided by 15, what is the remainder? And options are there. Options are 12, 10, 3 and 1. Now you see the successive terms are factorial 1, it is 1, factorial 2, it is 2, factorial 3 is 3 into 2 is 6, factorial 4 is equal to 4 into 3 into 2, 24. And after that, factorial 5, it is 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. You see, it is divisible by 15. Factorial 5 is divisible by 15. Then factorial 6, it will be 6 into factorial 5. As because it is divisible by 15, so whole thing, that is, this is divisible by 15. So this way, we can claim that all terms after factorial 4 means factorial 5, factorial 6, factorial 7, up to factorial 95, all are exactly divisible by 15. So remainder will come from these 4. They are not divisible by 15. Their sum is 33. So to calculate remainder after dividing by 15, remainder is, actually remainder is when 33 is divided by 15, which is simply 3. The option is, third option is correct. Next. if a and b are coefficient of x to the power n in 1 plus x to the power 2n and 1 plus x to the power 2n minus 1, then the value of a by b. Once again, I am repeating the problem. A is the coefficient of x to the power n in that binomial, and b is the coefficient of x to the power n in that binomial, then value of a by b. And options are there: 2 into n minus 3 by 5, 2 into n minus 4 by 5, 2 into n plus 3 by 5, 2 into n plus 4 by 5. These are the options. This is n minus 4 by 5. Achha. So the problem, about the problem, we follow it. Achha, now, for the expansion, say 1 plus x to the power n, we know that this expansion is 1 plus nc1 into x plus nc2 into x square and so on. In that case, coefficient of x squared is nc2, coefficient of x cubed is nc3 and so on. So, in this expansion, n is not n here, it is 2n. So, coefficient of x to the power n, that is a, this a is equal to 2n cn. And in that expansion, coefficient of x to the power n is b. So b is equal to 2n minus 1 cn. And we have to simplify it. Nothing else. It is equal to factorial 2n, this one, by factorial n into factorial of that difference. For that calculation, it is factorial of 2n minus 1, factorial of n, and factorial of n minus 1, this minus that. One factorial n cancels. They together is 2n in numerator, and they together, this is one more than that, n. Oh, it is equal to simply 2. Okay, what is our answer? Sorry, these options are not correct. Actual options are 2, 3, 4, and 5. So, option A is correct. Actually, I copied the options for next question. So, answer is 2. In next question, in a minus 2b whole to the power n, sum of fifth term and sixth term is 0, then value of a by b is, options are that. Now here, the binomial is without x, is a minus 2b whole to the power n, and sum of fifth and sixth term is 0, it is given. So as per condition, t5 is equal to nc4 into first term, that is a to the power n minus 4 into minus 2b to the power 4 plus the fifth term. Now sixth term is nc5 a to the power n minus 5 into minus 2b to the power 5, that is equal to 0. Now you see, deep this term is negative and that term is positive. So we can write nc4 a to the power n minus 4 2 to the power 4 into b to the power 4 is equal to nc5 a to the power n minus 5 minus is already counted 2 to the power 5 into b to the power 5. So they together is only 2. They together is only b. So we get nc4 a to the power n minus 4 is equal to nc5 into a to the power n minus 5 into 2 into b. A to the power n minus 4 minus 2 to the power that. It is nc5 a to the power this minus 2 to the power 2b to the power 5 is equal to 0. Nc4 nc5 a to the power this 2 to the power 5 b to the power 5. So okay, now when this and that they cancel, it is this one is one more. So a, that is a by b is equal to a by b. This is a by b is equal to nc5 by nc4, this by that, and a and b is there into 2, this 2. It is equal to 2 into nc5 is factorial n by factorial 5 into factorial of n minus 5 into in denominator factorial n, nc4 is factorial n into factorial of 4 into factorial of n minus 4. It is equal to 2. They together is this and that. It is n minus 4. They together is 5 over there. So 2 into n minus 4 by 5. So second option is correct. Okay. Today is up to this. In next video, I will discuss so many few more problems. Thank you for today.